As we were made aware of Donald Trump's candidacy in these United States elections for president, the first thing that had to come into question was leadership. And he has been successful in real estate and is successful in reality TV for his humor, if you will. So I understand how some people may think that he has enough skills in leadership to be a leader. But when you're talking about being the leader of the free world and the head of the decision-making processes in the world, when you sit at the UN, you have to question who supports him and what he is all about. And I think as we have sit back and watched all of this unfold, we are starting to see the type of individuals who supported him financially. And I've posted articles, and I've sent them all to Benny Thompson, and I have shed some light here in the state of Ohio on some of the profiling and bigoted results that we have been getting from these same supporters. I have decided, because I was inspired by a family and even asked the question of what Sir Thomas More was going to do to create a better world for our children. And I began to do some soul searching, because I had been through a lot of the battles that we face in life and had needed someone to save me in a way. And as I thought about all the other people in the world who were worse off than I was, and I thought about these children asking me about Sir Thomas More, it lit a fire in me. It lit a fire in me to tell them who I was, because I had been in a relationship to where that I was muffled, if you will, so as to allow people to take advantage of me. And it caused me a lot of mental anguish, kind of like our country, really. We're tired of hearing about these things over and over on television. We need positive things in our life, like the voices that were asking me about Sir Thomas More's plan for utopia and making me smile and forget about my problems for a while. And so I announced to them something that I hadn't told anyone outside of the walls that I grew up in, and that is that my family is famous. They are famous for change. They are famous for America, and they did produce some great soldiers in all of the wars, but none greater than the one who sat at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue when he decided to make some change. I can't explain to you the disgust and the disdain that I felt when I seen uneducated people disrespect that office that President Jackson sat in. Like that you're allowed to just walk in and take over, start moving furniture around, not realizing who had sat in them seats before you, the sacrifices that some families had made to bring us to this great place in history where the United States shall rise again, and it shall rise through the truth being told, through faith in our democracy, and through education provided through a campaign called U.S. for Hope, where we teach to children the truth at crowdfunding and crowd gathering places like sports arenas, museums, and concerts, let alone Kings Island, Disney World, and some of the NASCAR World Soccer attendances. We shall rise because we're going to ask a question about what Jesus would do. Something that gets overlooked in our country too much. What Jesus would do is, he would ask for the Muslims, the Hindus, the Buddhists, the agnostic, and the others to take 15 minutes in the morning to bring peace to their mind and pray, or to allow others to do so. In an act of discipline, so that our children understand how to make a plan for the day and ask for guidance through faith to whomever. Number two, I think that in the U.S. for Hope campaign, we may touch on things like pledging our allegiance to that flag that should fly in every classroom, as we begin to recite the Star Spangled Banner, so that even our foreign students can understand that on our soil, we are serious about our country. Instead of being upset and turning it into a racial divide, when my friend Colin Kaepernick brings attention to a problem in the United States by kneeling at a spectacle so that everyone will ask what the problem is instead of ignore it, we shall thank him for allowing such a significant piece of time for us to reflect on the problem in this country and to learn more about how to solve it. That's being an American. That's doing it by the Constitution. That's taking a really close look at the Bill of Rights and allowing us to ponder together with him in unity to find a solution. We should then go on about our day, learning, educating, and listening. Because if that's what's going to get America across the bridge that we're trying to build to a utopia, I think that things that are out there where many, many families are attending, SeaWorld and such, can be the perfect place to ask for help for our citizens who may have never seen the inside of an amusement park, concert, or theater. Because their financial situation is dire. And I think that if we use this campaign for helping our society along and creating more initiative amongst our children and assisting our teachers in the education of them, that we'll end up better off not only as Democrats, but as Americans, as we move on from this Donald Trump scenario.